Thank you, Dr. Satyendra. Good morning to all of you. Yeah, respected Joint Secretary, Marketing, Sri P.K. Swain ji, respected Director, Marketing, Mr. Meena ji, Marketing Department officials, DMI officials, my faculty colleagues, and Mandi secretaries, Mandi traders, and my dear farmers, and research interns, and my dear students. For us, it's a matter of great privilege. This is a National Institute on Agriculture Marketing, and Joint Secretary of Marketing taking time, coming here, and sparing one full day with us to discuss on various aspects of agriculture marketing and delivering a lecture on eNAM, One Nation, One Market, on this occasion is a matter of great privilege for us. Sir, thank you for taking time and with love and affection towards NIAM, coming here and delivering the lecture for the benefit of the people. And I would like to take opportunity to welcome all others to this very important Krishi Gyan Deep lecture series. Few words about Krishi Gyan Deep lecture series. We all know that, you know, we live in a very big country, 6.25 lakh villages and 130 million farmers. Marketing is very, very important aspect for everyone in their profession. It is very difficult for us to communicate and connect with everyone in this country sitting here in Jaipur and being part of this National Institute. Therefore, the idea of Krishi Gyan Deep. The Krishi Gyan Deep is a platform where the prominent speakers, practitioners, policy makers, administrators, academicians, they come to NIAM, use the platform of Krishi Gyan Deep and share their experiences, interact with the students and faculty, clarify all their doubts, and the direct audience for this Krishi Gyan Deep are our students and faculty members. But this hall, we have invisible and indirect audience. Their entire country, the officers and other stakeholders who are working for strengthening agriculture marketing systems. We are going to record the entire talk, including the interaction, and that will be converted into a film. And through NIAM YouTube channel, we place there. At the same time, we have around 15 to 20,000 email IDs. That is, we have a very big mailing list involving individuals and institutions who are working for agriculture development, not only within the country, even outside the country. And these films, links are sent to all the people for watching. Now, the advantage, subsequent advantage of this talk are enormous. In an institution, they don't have the privilege of calling prominent speaker to state level and district level institutions. But through this, they have an advantage of listening to them for one full hour on a particular topic, followed by, most importantly, the question and answer sessions. Basically, they're all frequently asked questions, frequently arised questions in the minds of different stakeholders. Those questions are asked by our students and faculty members so that not only it is a one-way monologue, it is a dialogue between the speaker and the audience. So this dialogue is captured in the form of a film and communicated to individuals and institutions across the country. And as of now, sir, we have completed 5 Krishi Gyan Deep talks on by prominent speakers on doubling farmers' income, on sustainable agriculture, on contract farming, and direct marketing by farmers, linking farmers to market, and this is the sixth in the series. And this topic is very, very important for us because the entire country is looking at eNAM as a positive disruption in the field of agriculture marketing. I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate Joint Secretary of Marketing for receiving the Changemaker Award instituted by Business Line. And this very recently, the Joint Secretary received this award from Honorable former Prime Minister of this country, Dr. Manmohan Singh. Sir, this indicates that the system which you are trying to promote across the country play very, very important role in bringing larger benefits to the farmers. So we would like to play a small role by communicating the benefits of this eNAM to different stakeholders who are located at state level, district level and below through ICT platform. So in this context, this talk is very, very important for us. And again, I would like to thank you and welcome you again for this talk. Now, regarding the speaker, of course, I think it is needless to, introduce the speaker. The speaker is known across the country. Whoever deals with agriculture development and agriculture marketing, and he is very popular. But however, I would like to give a brief introduction. Shri P.K. Swain is basically by academics, he is an engineer. And because of his diversified interest, later, he did several postgraduate programs, like developmental economics and even in a foreign language also, several postgraduate programs he has completed. Then he joined Indian Postal Service and he gave, very memorable contribution, especially in northeastern states. And later he came back to ministry, not only in agriculture ministry, in different ministries, in different roles. He made a contribution and joined agriculture ministry initially as director marketing, and he played very important role in what are all the programs we are seeing in the field today. And subsequently joined as joint secretary marketing, and as joint secretary marketing he brought several policy reforms and popularizing marketing programs across the country. To name a few, APLM Act, throughout the country, workshops are being organized involving all the stakeholders at the state level to create awareness about APLM Act. And eNAM is another very important contribution of Joint Secretary. And on eNAM, state level interactions are taking place to popularize this, not only between the mandis, even between the states. So this interstate trading is becoming very popular because of the contributions and efforts made by Honorable Joint Secretary. And Contract Farming Act is also released, and now awareness is created on that. And several new programs like Agriculture Marketing Infrastructure Programs, AgmarkNet, and many more programs like that. New programs are introduced and all efforts are made to take the benefits to the farmers. So with this introduction, sir, again, I would like to welcome you. It is our privilege and request you to deliver the talk on eNAM, One Nation, One Market. Thank you very much.
Good morning to all of you. I am Prasant Kumar Swain, working in the Ministry of Agriculture in the Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare, Government of India, in Krishi Bhavan, New Delhi. I have been requested to speak on eNAM, One Market, One Nation. You must be wondering, what is eNAM? What is market? And what is one market? And what is one market for one nation? Let me try to cover the entire gamut in this. Of course, my focus will be on the eNAM. I'll try my best to bring it to you. eNAM, I'll speak in English because probably it's a heterogeneous audience. I hope all of you understand English, so I'll cover it in English, and so that in case any difficulty is there, you can ask me. eNAM stands for E National Agriculture Market. It is a E means it's a electronic for the market, for the trading. So it's a e-trading platform. It's a virtual e-trading platform which is joined the physical markets in India, that is particularly the regulated wholesale markets, to create a kind of unified platform cutting across the market where farmers can trade, farmers can sell their produce anywhere, the trader can buy anywhere. So e-National Agriculture Market, which stands for eNAM, is meant to be an e-trading virtual platform which will join these physical markets to facilitate the farmers to sell to a bigger numbers of traders. So let's look at the objective of the eNAM. Objective is to provide, there are various objectives. The first objective is to provide a transparent, competitive bidding system backed by a remunerative mechanism for the price realization by the farmers. That's the first phase. The second, of course, is starting the inter-mandi trade. When first one was meant for within the mandi, within the market, within that regulated wholesale market, the second is meant to join mandis within the state to create a kind of a unified market within a state, because it has to be a step-by-step approach. And the next objective is that joining these markets in a state to the markets in other state within India to create a pan-India market. You must be wondering what is this market and what is the pan-India market. As you know, agriculture marketing is a state subject. In the Constitution of India, in the federal structure, the states have been, states have certain role to play, certain power to execute, and agriculture as well as agriculture marketing is a state subject. It is within the purview of the state. So that is why the state APMC Acts have come up to regulate what? The wholesale trading, not the retail. This act only regulates the wholesale trading. Retail is something different. So wholesale means when the farmer harvests, at the time of harvest, the produce size increases because it's a big lot. The harvest, depending on the size of the land that he's tilling, the harvest is a big lot. So the farmer has to bring the lot either once or twice to the market in that season of harvest. It's a big lot. So the farmer must get a good price for the big lot. When all the big lots come together to the market at a time, what happens? The supply aggregation happens in the market, whereas the demand is not increasing at that point of time. So the price reduces. So typically in a harvest season, you'll see the price slump is there, because the act provides that there has to be traders, the commission agents, depending on the state, and the farmers. Farmers are not regulated, but definitely the other two category in the wholesale regulated market. Traders have to, depending on the states, pay market fee of different nature when they are trading and buying actually this wholesale stuff in the market. Retails are happening outside these markets. Retails are the smaller ones, like you and I buy it for our daily needs in the market from the retail shops or from other chains. Because you know the supply chain from the farm to the fork has various stages. So when this regulation is happening, the acts have been pretty old. Many of these states have come up in 60s and 70s. The markets have remained isolated. Each market had its own trader. Each market had its own commission agent. Consequently, when the farmer used to bring the entire commodity of his harvest commodity to the nearest wholesale market, then the same traders who are registered or licensed in that mandi will be bidding, probably over a period of time, leading to kind of monopoly by the traders, because they will dictate they are paying money. So all kinds of different trade practices happen, which for the today's analyst are not desirable. What they call it, non-transparent. Given this non-transparency, at the receiving end was the farmer, and he could only sell it to the trader within that mandi. If he had to sell to the trader in another mandi, he has to physically take it to another mandi. You know, the mandi densities, the wholesale mandi densities are not too good. I mean, I should not use the word too good. It's in fact the biggest in the world. But then, in terms of our small and marginal farmers, it actually challenges the accessibility of the farmer. We have about 6,630 wholesale mandi, regulated mandis in India, including both primary mandis and the subyards, the principal market ward, what we call, and the subyards. The density is something like 496 square kilometer. When you calculate it, it comes to about 496 square kilometer, thereby meaning a diameter of about nearly 24 to 25 kilometer. That means there is an issue of accessibility for the farmers, because 86% of our farmer are small and marginal, thereby meaning lesser than 2 hectares of land, almost less than 4.75 acres of land. That means their produce is small, their economic capacity is small, their ability to deal with the market is always limited. Whereas the wholesale markets deal with the bigger lots. The lots brought by the small and marginal farmers are even not sufficient for a trader to pick up, because their need is much more, because they have to economize the entire logistic cost. And over the period of time, when these mandis were regulating, the infrastructure development was also a challenge. The other issue is the trade language. Same commodity, same variety of commodity is known by different name in different markets. Whereas we had given to the country the AgMark from the British period. 1937 Act defines the AgMark quality standard. But the market never picked up that in the trade. They had their local trade name for this trading. That means when you are trading from one mandi to the other mandi, the quality could not be standardized. So that was a barrier to the development of the trade on a smooth basis across the market on an all India basis. Why all India? You know, every country has its own agroclimatic zone. The productions are of particular type limited to that area. Apple grows in, say, Jammu Kashmir, the biggest volume, followed by Himachal, then probably by Uttarakhand and Arunachal. But the consumption is not limited to only Jammu Kashmir, Himachal. If it is only limited to those states, the price will be very low, because the limited buyers will be there. But the demand generates from elsewhere, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Andaman to Lakshadweep, from Tripura to Gujarat. I'm talking about east, west, north, south. In Jaipur, they need apple. In Kerala also, they need apple. In Lakshadweep also, they need apple. So the apple has to be, apple as a commodity has to pass from the originating producing belt to the consumption belt, which is spread all across India. You know, it is not just India. If the export is there, the market is more. What are the marketing channels for farmers? Definitely one is the procurement that the government is doing, but everything cannot be procured. So it has to come to the domestic market. The third is the processing. Fourth is the export market. I'm not touching upon because I have to limit to the eNAM. So even export market, they have to also, like the apple of Kashmir or Himachal, move to the Middle East, because the entire Indian diaspora is there in Middle East. Look at the ASEAN region, there is also the Indian diaspora. Indians are there in USA, but then it has to be exported. But let's now confine ourselves to the domestic market. At least we have to ensure that our domestic market performs well, the efficiency is better. We have to connect to the farmers, we have to give them the opportunity to the market. And we realize that when we are reforming, we gave the APLM Act, which is a change from 2003 Model Act, the Model APLM Act of 2017, to further liberalize it in the steps. We provided for the e-trading provision, which was not there earlier in that act. Because we realized that if we have to connect these markets, it's a virtual platform which is to come. Virtual platform can be accessed 24/7 from anywhere, whereas the physical markets have the limitations of time. Because there are officers who come at 9 o'clock, go back by 5 o'clock or maybe 6 o'clock. Those who work hard a little more, they probably 7 o'clock. So the market stops during beyond this time. But whereas, why only during this time? Virtual platform can provide any time. During the harvest, you'll see the farmers are lining up, but the market closes in the earlier days. So we thought if the virtual platform is there, it can work in the night also. Not necessarily it has to only work during the daytime. So the market structure efficiency is very important to improve. Quality is another. We realize that the quality is important because for the pricing. The quality is in a conventional market is done by the trader who does by his own experience, by his own way. Somebody presses the paddy in the teeth and says, this is the mush. Somebody throws it in the air, says, this is the color, so this is the mush. There is no standardized method. Probably from trader to trader, quality can vary. It's just it's a very subjective assaying. It's not assaying, it's not a scientific assaying. So it was very important that we introduce in the market an assaying facility when doing this virtual e-trading, so that the farmer gets the proper price for the product that he's bringing in. A trader may say this is the best quality, the other trader may say the worst quality. If that point of trading, the trader who is saying best quality is not available, so the other traders who are not really saying it very good, good quality, so then they'll be trading. So that means farmer will be at disadvantage. So that is why we thought there has to be a scientific method of assaying, and it should be uploaded in the bidding platform, in the virtual platform, so that anybody can see. It is a very, very scientific. Even if you change the machine, they have to be the same, anytime, anywhere. So that means the farmer's remuneration will be linked to a very scientific process of assaying. So that is why when we did this virtual platform, assaying concept was put in. The bidding, we realized that in the physical market, when the bidders stand around a heap that the farmer has brought in and they bid, sometimes the way, the manner in which they bid, the farmer is not able to understand that complexity of that bidding. And probably the commission agent, if that market has a commission agent, he knows some of the bidder, he brings in, so it is a limited bidding. If the bidding is open to the other members of the trading community outside even the market, that means the other traders outside this market, from anywhere they can take a bid, from other markets also. So that is why we thought there has to be a unified license procedure, so that the traders not only of that market to which the farmer brings the stuff, but the traders of the other market within the state should be able to also bid for the lot, for the produce that the farmer has brought into that market. So that is why we created a concept of unified license in the regulatory platform system. So we requested the states that you must have the unified license procedure on this platform. In fact, Telangana started it. They upgraded all the licenses as is where is basis to unified license. It was followed by Odisha and Uttarakhand. Now Andhra has followed it. Others are, of course, issuing the unified license. But then that is a process journey that we are having, and we are quickly moving towards a kind of unified license regime. The other, you realize that this bidding must be very, very competitive. So we created that anybody can bid from anywhere, not necessarily has to come to that physical market. You know, the internet penetration in India has improved substantially of late. So why not use that base to, on this trading platform to use it? 2013, probably we had 17 crore of internet users. Today, end of 2018, I'm told estimated to be more than 50 crore, more than 51 crore, three times. You know, India is a giant in terms of technology. Not only it is moving up fast in economy, thanks to digital economy, but also is moving up very fast. We have more than 100 crores of mobile today in India, which has been purchased for use. Why not use that space, that mobile should be my market, my mobile, my market? So that is why when we created this platform, we said that the bidding can be done by anybody by the mobile from anywhere. Once the bidding is there, over, the decision the system can take, they can choose the final winner. In a physical bid, the commission agent can change the final winner even, but here, it is a faceless platform which will decide who is the winner. Then thereafter, an agreement is to be generated, because any trade in the legal system is a contract. So the agreement system has to be generated automatically. Of course, we realize that not only agreement, but it's agreement between the farmer and the buyer, but also the seller and the buyer, but also there has to be an efficient mechanism of payment. So these are all shown in those six, this thing which I'm talking about. Why efficient? Because otherwise, you'll see in a physical standalone market generally, the payment is done in various methodology. If you have visited the market, it is done in various methodology over a period of, these are all traditional methods. Earlier, it was by the cash. Sometimes these are all discounted cash, in the sense, right, immediately they may not do the spot payment. It may be a deferred payment. It has a cost inbuilt into, in terms of the interest buried on that to the farmer, which a cost which comes on the farmer. If the farmer doesn't get all his 100% payment on the spot in that market, then obviously it is a locked in interest which is losing out. The other is the weighing. Before payment, we thought there has to be transparency in weighing. Weighing was done by the mechanical method. When you enter this way, probably 100 could be slightly modified, decimal can be changed, or digit may be changed, because manual, always human is to make error here or there. But if it is a digital weighing machine is used, electronic weighing machine is used, that means, like the assaying equipment, it will always give you the same up to the decimal figure, the weight up to the decimal figure. And the beauty of these electronic weighing scales are that they can be interfaced to our platform so that there is no need of human intervention in between. Interfacing is easy today. Like assaying equipments now, they have been developed so well that they can be interfaced to our system. The assaying parameters need not be fed to the system, they can be directly interfaced. We are developing the interface and we have started doing it. So, after similarly, the payment we devised various methods. They used to do the cash, then some of them used to give the check, some of them used to give the bank draft, some of them used to start going to the banks to transfer to the account, maybe RTGS, NEFT, depending on the time. NEFT is up to 6 p.m. in the evening, and RTGS up to 4, as per the RBI regulations. Now, when a payment is to be initiated in this e-payment, when the trader can do, he can do in the market, he can do sitting at home, he can do it through mobile from anywhere. He can do it through debit card, You can do it through internet. You can do it through Bheem. Bheem also you have introduced. It's a very, very fast payment. You initiate and then we have a back-end calculation by the system. Nobody manually, it is not being done. It's back-end calculation by the system. So it pushes the amount, it divides the amount, what the trader is paying, because it combines both the payment for the commodity, payment for the market fee, payment of the commission charges, and in case any Hamal charges is there, because Hamal has to be there. So it divides and then pushes to the respective account at the back end. The entire process probably takes half an hour maximum, depending on this system. Unless there is an error in the account numbers, say account number of the farmer, while entering they have done it. So it will never give that payment to that account. It will be held in suspense and it will come back. The Mandi secretary can see that on his dashboard that this could not go because of some problem in the account. Then maybe IFC code is wrong, maybe the account number is wrong, the branch code is wrong. So that then he has to connect to that farmer and get it corrected. You know, these datas are, at the time of commissioning of this software, the entire detail of the farmer is captured in that area, Mandi area. The trader's details are captured, like the name, father's name and all that. Even trader, that the license number is there, because he's a registered or a licensed trader. For the farmer, entire detail will be there. Village, land, everything will be there, what commodities is doing. There's a good number of 15, 16 fields are there which are entered in that at the time of commissioning of the eNAM in that market. Similarly, commission agents' details. Some of the states don't have commission agents like Madhya Pradesh, so they do it without the commission agent even. So given this, once the payment has been done, of course you have not made it compulsory, still traders are paying even through the check and other means. But of late we see the e-payment has picked up due to realization that this is instant and the farmers have started demanding it. So once the payment is done, then the information comes to the Mandi secretaries, then he releases the goods which goes out through the gate exit. So this is in overall the entire system of eNAM process that happens from gate entry to the assaying. When farmer brings his lot, there is a gate entry, because once the gate entry is there, every detail of that commodity, the farmer who has brought in, everything is there on the system. The traders can see it from anywhere. We have provided the traders the features of registration as favorites to those markets and to those commodities. If they want to trade in 10 different markets, in 15 different commodities, they can give it as a favorite, register themselves as for the favorite, and those notifications will come in their mobile. So that means they know when the arrival is there at the gate entry, they'll get a notification. So they are ready. If they want to beat, they can beat. And to facilitate the farmers to reduce the gate queue at the time of harvest, we have also provided an advanced lot registration system. The farmer, while leaving the village after he has loaded on the tractor or and the handcart to bring to the market, he can do the advanced lot registration, which is done at the gate. So he can pick up his mobile and do that. His name, the commodity that he's bringing, vehicle in which he's bringing, all these details he can fill up. So at the gate, he did not stand for very long. He shows his reference and gets in. We are promoting that advanced lot registration system with the farmers now. We are simplifying, because it's a digital platform. You can design the platform like anything. So when it is arriving in the gate, the traders also get a notification. They can bid. They can bid through their mobile. They can bid through the computer. Today, all mandis have started making their campus Wi-Fi, which was not possible earlier. The traders can use their mobile within the campus if they are there, free. It is a free Wi-Fi for them, and they can bid. If they are at home, of course, they have a mobile data, they can use it. All these apps are freely available for download in the Google App Store. Nothing is charged. Apps are purely free, whether the farmer, trader, commission agent, or anybody. For the farmers, when he's dealing with the eNAM, it's a real live prices he gets. Earlier, in our attempt, we had given the AgMark net, where the price is generally entered the previous day. That means today's price is not available, because at the end of the day, I find the markets are entering the prices of the entire days of trade, minimum, maximum, modal. But eNAM is one, when the live trade is happening, one can see what's the price. So farmer has a informed choice of going to that market at what time, point of time, whether to this market or to that market. If he can come to the other market where there is a better price, certainly he can do. And for the small and marginal farmers to come together to bid on this platform, we have provided facility for the APOs, cooperatives, to sell their produce on this platform. So aggregation is possible. They can aggregate their small lots, bring together, sharing the cost of transportation, bring it to the market as a APO or as a cooperative, and can upload it and sell it. Nothing is charged for assaying at the moment, not at all, which was not possible earlier. The market is doing today the assaying for the farmers, for their benefit, so that they get the better price. The bidding we are seeing, that the bidding is picking up. What do you mean by picking up? When we started our journey in 2016, 14th April, this was launched in 8 states in 21 mandis, the number of bids per lot, each arrival is given a label as a lot, a number is given, that identity carries on. The bidding for the lot was pretty low, because that was the beginning. Any digital revolutions will have different phases of its growth till maturity. So we saw that the number of bids per lot was very low, even less than 2. But during our journey, when the maturity, we started increasing the number from 21 mandis to 585 mandis by 31st March 2018, the people have started understanding about the potentiality of this platform, the benefit of this platform. So the bids have increased. Some of the first phase markets, which are commissioned in the very first phase in 2016-17, are even bidding, getting bids more than 20 per lot for some of the commodities, even more than 30. That something is to our delight, which the farmer could not think of in earlier days, olden days. For example, the cotton, the turmeric, where the prices are also based on the quality. And the quality testing is happening. The virtual platform has allowed now more bidders to access this commodity, this lot, to bid on that. Biddings are of two types. One is the open bidding, the other is the closed bidding. So typically in Andhra and Telangana, they're competing with each other, and we are getting very large number of bids per lot in some of these commodities. It's a journey towards a kind of Himalayan effort, Himalayan result. We'll see much more. And in the second phase of its objective, we have now connected about 10 states on the intermandate trade within the state. It's more than 600 crore of trade which has happened on this, and we are expecting much more now that we are facilitating. Recently, we started the interstate trade, made intensive effort on that, because it's a state agriculture marketing board. No state would like to, of its own, deal with another state on the eNAM platform to start this, permit this. But you'll be happy to know that we started in December in a very short span of time. In about 3 months' time, now 11 states have joined in that. But though volume may not be very high, when we started debating on this, Many of the mandi secretaries told me the vegetables cannot be traded on this, fruits cannot be traded on this. But the very first lot of interstate trade happened between Uttarakhand and UP. They're all vegetable. And they scaled up in the vegetable very fast. The traders themselves drove it, not the mandi. The traders themselves drove it. So they bought it from the farmer of the other state. Look at the beauty of this. The local farmer who was getting the traders of that mandi only, today is also can get a bid from the traders of other states. Not only from the traders of his own state from other mandis, but also traders from our. So the potentiality is too high. So that is why it's a journey, but then the challenges are many. Not that, in fact, government of India has been supporting this program while developing this platform. Also, states are given the financial assistance and other assistance, handholding, so that together we move. While this financial assistance are meant for various kinds of infrastructure setting up, computer, IT, assaying, because assaying was not a kind of culture in the mandi, so it has to be brought in. So assaying they have started getting it, electronic weighing scales. So those are the equipments now, modern equipments, which the mandis have started putting up, which they are lacking. Apart from this, we also provided this platform, commission, got it commission, provided a mandi analyst to each of the mandi for a year for doing the handholding in after the initial training. Initial intensive training was given to the mandi secretaries, traders, farmers, commission agent. But beyond that also, mandi analyst will be there for a year to do that handholding with the mandi. So that difficulty, because when suddenly from a physical space, there is a hop-stop jump to the digital space, it has a lot of challenges of acceptance. So the mandi analyst role was to explain, to help them do the handholding so that it transition becomes smooth. The biggest challenge that we had is, well, India is moving in terms of mobile, but use of the mobile has to be explained to the farmers. Initially, when we started our journey, we trained the farmers, traders, mandi secretaries, commission agent, at a time in the mandi. We realized probably we have to have a different level of communication skill with different level of stakeholders, different types of stakeholder. The traders are well educated, well equipped with the mobile system. They know how to operate it. But the, on the other hand, the farmers and the producers need to be trained intensively on this. So our effort was to make this entire program on the mobile and the computer very user friendly and easy. There is a digital divide in terms of age. So we started going to the village and made a small effort in going to the villages, rather Gram Sabhas, to talk to the farmers, explain them about the mobile system. While doing it, we came back with an idea that we must have an e-learning module. So the e-learning module was developed and put in the website. Then they said that website should have the real live price. We did a streaming of the live price on that website. Anybody can get, I mean, register themselves in the website and do that. And we realized that language is a barrier sometimes, though not the platform. Platform is absolutely no barrier. So we had this system of 9 languages. We are in the process of developing. We thought it should be easy for the farmer to deal with that eNAM platform. Though complexity is there on the backside, because to make it easy on the front end, you have to get into the complex level on the back end. That is what we are doing in the back end. But it has to be very easy, facile, user friendly. So for the farmers, we tried to bring in languages, easiness of handling that mobile. The SMS system, when the farmer does the registration, he gets SMS that he has been registered. When he does the lot entry, he will get that his stuff has entered the market. He can see now, today, the quality parameters on the mobile. this uploaded, the traders can see. If the trader is there 100 kilometers away from the mandi, he wants to bid. He can see the gate entry. Yes, his favorite lot has entered. The entire assaying parameters, whether he has to bid it or not, he will decide. Then during the bid, when the bid is progressing, in the open system, one can see how is it progressing. Probably, if you see that screen typically, for the progress of the bid, there will be flashing. That means, whatever was the last bid, if a next bid comes above that price, there will be flashing in the screen. Then you can know that now higher bid has come. Then I can decide as a buyer whether if I'm so keen to take it because it's still very attractive that price, then I'll bid it still higher. I'll revise my bid. As a trader, I can revise my bid. Then the trader community wanted that they should be able to trade in many multiple markets in multiple commodities at a time. Need not be only one market at a time bidding. So we provided a subcard system where they can choose multiple markets and multiple commodities and put the bid in that. Even the traders requested that suppose we have got 10 bids, we have owned 10 bids, we should make only one single payment, not 10 different payments. In the physical system, they make each single payment. So we have now combined, because it's all digital platform, we work together with the developer, and we have now provided that bunching of the payment. 10 payments can be made through one payment by that trader. But at the back end, my system exactly knows to whom how much has to go, and it goes quickly within that half an hour entire year. So bunching of the payment has also been added. That means it economizes the time and the cost to the trader. That means earlier, for each payment, probably in the bank, he used to pay some fee to his own bank. eNAM, we do not charge anything for the e-payment that we carry out in the eNAM. It is free. But bank to bank, they charge. Some of the banks may make it free. Some of the banks may make it. They charge a little fee to the account holder. But currently, earlier they used to probably pay some fee every time. But now maybe 10 payment or 20 payments, it's only one payment through the bank. So it is optimizing their time, optimizing their effort, and making it very easy to handle it. So that means, if you see for the trader's perspective, it is not that his time of trading within the market is reducing drastically. He is not required to be physically present. He can bid sitting in his home with a unified license in 10 markets, 20 markets, 50 commodities, which was never possible earlier. It was only one market, maybe one commodity. Physically, he used to go to the commodity and bid. But now, it's a faceless bidding where he can do multiple bidding in multiple markets. It's virtually free from any physical limitations. So that means a small and marginal trader, I'm introducing this concept of small and marginal trader, like a small and marginal farmer, if they want to increase their business, there is a huge opportunity. A pan-India business they can enter into. And for the farmer, he is an informed seller. He can see it in his mobile, the prices. He can see the bid in progress. He can see his quality. He can see the bid in progress. If he doesn't want to sell at that price, which is finally come, he has the choice to say no. That means no agreement will be generated after that. He wants to sell at that price, then the agreement will be generated. It depends on the farmer to say yes or no for the final price in the bid that he is getting, which was unthinkable in a physical space earlier, physical trading earlier. So in this entire platform, we are bringing the transparency, the competitiveness, and remunerative price based on the quality, the prompt payment system, the accurate weighing system, and of all, the entire time is reducing. The turnaround time that industry uses generally or for a rail, when the rail carriage is going to a port and unloading and turn around, or a ship turning around in that port, you can use that terminology of turnaround for a farmer or a trader is now small. Turnaround time. That means time is money, value. Time is value. So we are optimizing the time. Certainly, we are now making the mandi management in the bidding process very standardized, effective. So mandis are now following a standard procedure across, cutting across the states, cutting across the, within the state even. So it is a kind of efficiency to the marketing structure within the mandi and from mandi to mandi. The other issue is that when you are coming on the digital platform, the cost involved in the entire system is reducing drastically. Cost, because the trader doesn't have to come here. The farmer who is to spend more than a day for his produce in a wholesale mandi at the time of harvest, now probably he can go back on the same day. And if the mandi makes it little faster, that means the delay in the entire system is the delay due to the human delay. That means assaying has been done, but mandi secretary for some reason has not been able to put to the bidding process. Once the assaying is done, immediately thereafter, mandi secretary can put it to bidding, say for 2 hours bidding or 3 hours bidding. Once the bidding is over, the winner is declared by the system. The SMS is going to the farmer, SMS is going to the trader, winner trader, and also the information is coming to the secretary. He has to ensure that the weighing takes place after taking the option of the farmer, whether to sell or not. So that means it's the human. And it is the mandis who are maturing, they are able to reduce their human time taken for intermodule time, intermodule delay. So now the time is shrinking gradually in this e-trading platform. So that means it is reducing the cost also drastically. And now the states have also trying to, once they are realizing this, they are trying to also reduce the market fee. Earlier the market fee was there for various reasons. But now they have started realizing this, they have started giving discount on the market fee, because the cost is reducing. So why have that kind of market fee now? Even with a lower market fee, they can manage it well. So many of the states have come up, even Rajasthan has come up. They have done a very novel thing. They have given the discount on that market fee and transferring it to the farmers. This is from the farmer's welfare point of view. So similarly, Madhya Pradesh is also giving, many of the states have now come up in giving the discount on the market fee. Even states like Uttar Pradesh are celebrating, they are holding this 14th of every month as the eNAM day, awarding those farmers who are on this, awarding those traders who are, like for the farmers, they probably call it eNAM Krishak Sri. For the trader, probably eNAM Sri. And even the mandi secretary, who is actually doing, encouraging this e-trade and coming up with maximum trade. So now the states from the first phase have moved and realized that it's in the interest of the farmers. So that is why. But the challenges are many. I'm not saying that challenges, but the states are trying, while bringing the internet speed depends on the internet speed, because in the infrastructure segment, we had recommended about 5 to 10 Mbps lease line. Most of the mandis have got it now, because it took some time, but they have got it now. They have made the, many states, they have made the mandi Wi-Fi. But then in some of the cases, sometimes if the internet speed goes down, that slight delay is there. But it is still faster than the physical. So we are monitoring that. And now the entire process is monitorable, which is not possible. The mandi secretary, for mandi secretary, you have created a dashboard. The dashboard provides the entire detail about his mandi in front of him in his room on his mobile even. he can see from number of farmers, their account, or the trade which is happening currently, or the trade which has happened in the past, the historical data. The graphs are there, charts are there. He can always see. We have recently created an interstate dashboard where the traders of other states applying for the license to his mandi can also get the, that is being expedited. So the dashboard is now, where earlier in a physical mandi there was no MIS or dashboard system, it was all pen and paper registers. Today, the dashboards are there. In his computer, he can see the dashboard. He can see the performance live very clearly. Not only mandi secretary, but the mandi board MDs can see for entire mandi or any specific mandi, for any specific period or entire period, every kind of data is there in very nice charts and graphs, easily comprehensible. Even what we have done is, if there is a problem in the digital, if there is any problem, there is a module you have created for the mandi secretaries where can all the problems they are there, they can log into this troubleshooting. So once it comes, then it can be monitored, and on the back end, then we work towards sorting out those, resolving those problems. We have a WhatsApp group. We have a WhatsApp group where all of us are joined in that WhatsApp group, and we keep exchanging. When I was just sitting here, I just entered your hall for your lecture. I just got a WhatsApp that in Swansan Monday, there is a server is little held up. So immediately I stood out here on the stage that what is the problem? I asked my troubleshooter. Now they are working on it. Quickly it will be resolved. It must have been resolved by now. So that means the monitoring of the every process from management to trade to settlement, everything is there on the dashboard today. And that is how I'm saying to the farmers that your mobile is your market. The market system has entirely descended on the mobile today. So with interstate and intermandi trade, we are able to now go to the next level. We are working for various futuristic plan today. APLM Act provides for the first time, APLM Act 2017, that the warehouse to be declared as the mandi. The significance is that earlier, the commodity from the field used to come to the mandi, and after that, if it is to be stored, it can go to the warehouse. We realized that it involves a lot of wastage in the system. Every time loading, unloading, you put it, there is a problem. There is a stress, both in terms of physical stress and thermal stress and the metabolic stress to the commodity. Because you know, these commodities, they're life. Like the fruits, they say there is a metabolic process, they breathe inside, if you know that entire mechanism. We have to control that metabolic process. So why this commodity to undergo? So we thought, let us reduce. So if the stuff can come to the warehouse or the cold storage, then there is a lot of saving time, saving in wastages, and easiness, because the transportation cost is reduced for the farmer, headache reduces. Whereas the warehouse is much more closer to the farm gate, so it will be easy. So we are now developing the eNAM software program. We are now fine tuning that eNAM program for the warehouse trading. We are working hand in hand with Warehouse Development Regulatory Authority and the entire team to sync this to their software and ours so that we are able to do this currently. In fact, now also we are working to go to the next level of platform. The first level of generation of platform that we had servers, Megra's cloud servers of NIC. Now we have now taken the next level of servers we are working. Very soon we'll be coming on that platform, which will be much more even faster. Because time is shrinking. So we need to shrink that time in eNAM further. So that is why we are now working on that. Apart from several other features we are bringing. So to ensure that the eNAM becomes one of the most effective platform, not just in the state, not just in the India, in our country, but in the entire world. In fact, friends, I have not come across a country where so many markets, physical wholesale markets, are joined in a single platform today to facilitate and promote the interstate trade. We may call it state, some country may call it province. I'm sure this will be a kind of torch bearer for the entire globe. India is rising. It's a digital India, make in India. And eNAM is not only the part of digital India, but it is a make in India. It's our effort, our own participation. All of us have participated, from farmers to the administrator, to make this journey a transformation. It is not just about digital. It is a transformational process that we have undertaken ourselves. So that is why, as Director General said, the Hindu group, the Hindu business line, which was initially a critics, has done their independent check. And they have declared their prestigious Changemaker Digital Transformation Award this year for eNAM. Thank you very much.
So I have a suggestion, like, so जैसे हमने पिछले कुछ सालों में देखा है कि जैसे कि कुछ सोशल मीडिया कैंपेन चले गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से, जैसे कि एक था हैशटैग फिटनेस चैलेंज, या फिर हम कह सकते हैं कि एक बार अभी एक जो हमारा स्वच्छ भारत अभियान था उसके लिए भी एक चैलेंज आया था. उसमें सबने कहा था कि जैसे दो फोटोज अपलोड करते थे, एक उस जगह का फोटो जब वो जगह क्लीन नहीं थी और एक उसके बाद का फोटो जब वो क्लीन थी. तो इस तरह के बहुत सारे चैलेंजेस आए और वो चैलेंजेस तब आए जब मतलब उन एरियाज में अवेयरनेस नहीं थी. तो हमने जब मंडीज विजिट की तो हमें पता चला कि जो ये स्कीम है ये मतलब हर एक स्टेक होल्डर को कुछ ना कुछ बेनिफिट दे रही है. लेकिन डिस्पाइट ऑफ दैट क्या हुआ कि फार्मर्स को जितने मैग्नीट्यूड के ऊपर उस स्कीम्स या फिर जितनी भी गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स हैं उनके बारे में पता नहीं है उसके बारे में. तो क्यों ना हमने ऐसा क्यों नहीं किया पिछले कुछ सालों में कि एक हैशटैग चैलेंज फार्मर्स के लिए भी आए. उसमें ऐसा हो सकता था कि जितने भी यहाँ पे लोग हैं अगर उनको एक टास्क दिया जाता कि फार्मर्स को अवेयर करा जाए किसी भी स्कीम के बारे में. मान लो हमने उनको एक वेबसाइट दी और वेबसाइट पे एक जैसे आपने बताया कि ई नाम का प्रोसेस बहुत सिंपल है. कोई भी स्टूडेंट जो कि जिसने ग्रेजुएशन की हुई है वो अच्छे से समझ सकता है और समझा भी सकता है. तो हम क्यों ना ऐसा करें कि एक हैशटैग चैलेंज चलाएं, उसके ऊपर लिखें कि आई सपोर्ट द फार्मर. उसके बाद कोई भी स्टूडेंट या फिर कोई भी बंदा जो कि कंसेप्ट को समझ सकता है वो एक ब्रांड एम्बेसडर की तरह किसी भी फार्मर के पास जाए, उसको कंसेप्ट को समझाए अच्छे से और एक फोटो अपलोड करे और बताए कि मैंने अपना चैलेंज पूरा किया. थैंक यू.
सर्टनली आई अप्रिशिएट दैट, विल कीप इट इन माइंड. बट वी हैव ऑल्सो टेकन स्टेप्स टू पॉपुलराइज द फार्मर्स. देयर इज नो वन पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस वी रियलाइज ऑफ publicity or awareness campaign that can appeal to all across the nook and cranny of this country. There has to be several methods, and one of them is this hashtag can be there. Recently I got a suggestions that we should provide the success story, and apart from that all the Government of India schemes. In fact, Government of India schemes are already there in many websites. If you look into our DSE and FW website, the schemes are there. If you look into the DMI websites, the schemes are there. So most of the government websites are providing these schemes. And the extension activities on the schemes are done not just by the extension workers of the state, but also by the bankers and many of the other organizations in various states. Even Mandi Board also does that, because physically when they come, the farmer come, sit with the extension worker or the Mandi Board, there they explain it, or the Gram Sabha also. That physical contact of explaining is very powerful in the villages. We realize that digital divide in the age. When we went to the Gram Sabha, though of course we have not concretized that idea, but we realize that 40 and less, the youngsters, they are able to pick up this digital platform very easily. You know, India demographically is a very powerful nation today, very powerful country today. It's for the future, a challenge to all the countries. When the Europe is aging, you must have seen the demographic profile, USA is aging. You look at any of them, UK, Germany, France, Spain. China is much better. But if you look at India is much better than China. Today, 50% of the population is below 25. 2/3 of the population is below 35. That means it's a young nation, which is good for the economy. The GDP is going to have a young economy. Till it ages, it has time span to now grow. If we grow at 7% regularly, till my workforce comes to that higher age, like what Europe underwent after the post-World War II, will certainly take over any nation. So these young people, they are today are able to get easily acquainted with the digital thing. But the farming is very traditional, where we realize that is the farmers who are, they are still very attached like any other farmer, and they do this. For them, when he prepared that e-learning module, went to the Gram Sabha, it is not once, but we have to do it more than once. Ek bar samjhane se nahi hoga, you have to train them time and again. You have to show them physically on the mobile. But the younger generation can pick up from all this, whether it is WhatsApp, Facebook, whether it is a movie, is a e-learning module, or even the hashtag, everything, younger generations. So certainly there is, that is why I said there is no one method of, because India, you have diversity of ways, diversity of practices. So you have to adopt many. So that is why we have decided now, when we are moving on the website, we'll put all the best practices so that the others can see it. So the Mandi board can upload what the best practices they're following. So the others can see and follow it. And training is no different from it, because we are focusing on training. And currently in the very initial phase, I still call it an initial phase, eNAM is yet to mature, because we are now going from infancy, we'll go into the adulthood. So in this stage, when we are making a journey, the training is very, very important, and it has to be at the village level, very clearly. Internet speed in the village level is yet to gain that, it is improved, it is improving. But more than that, when you explain to the farmer ABC, he understands it very easily. That is why we have been working with the Mandi board to take it to the village level, sit to the farmers. When nobody else is there, sit to the farmers. And we realize the farmers cutting across the age are taking a lot of interest to learn it. It's a kind of e-patsala. Just uploading a film will not do in this case. Sending a WhatsApp message will not do in this case. Sending a SMS will not do in this case. The learning has to be a contact learning process initially. Once everybody is familiar with this, any digital type of learning will be easier to them. Because currently, we realize when you observe them in the village Gram Sabha, we saw the farmers are able to use the, there are different types of users of the mobile. The younger generation is able to use the apps very easily. Very easily. Younger generation is able to use the apps very easily. But when the age is increasing, it's only dialing a number which they know which place. I mean, it's in the spectrum of the use. One, they are versatile, the younger generation. The other, they are only single use. You know, if you see the statistics, the population in the age group up to 35 constitute about 55% of the app use in India. Almost, I was reading a statistics, which means the app use is very popular with the younger generations. So that is why we need to adopt various methods. Currently, we are adopting a contact method, e-learning module. You know, when the farmer brings his stuff, we are asking the Mandi board to put the television in the farmer's restroom, Kisan Bhavan, where the videos are run. Then we have the electronic ticker board where the price is displayed in the Mandi. And within the Mandi itself, from the gate, you'll find they have put the hoardings. If you go to Mandis, they have put the hoardings near the gate, and then they have given the directions for it, eNAM. Then they have started the public announcement system. When during the harvest, farmer come to the Mandi, Now the mandis are doing the public announcement system to tease, talk about the eNAM. That something is a good learning ground for the farmers, because the farmers love to see what his neighbor is doing, his friend is doing. So if it's a learning, not by individual learning, also by the mass. So we are using those, all these techniques in the mandi, outside mandi, including digital platform to train them. Whereas our effort, though it is an Android-based system currently with an open source architecture, but now we are realizing that the traders who are most of the urbanistic, they are also using the iOS system. So now our developer, we have asked them to develop the iOS-based mobile platform so that we increase the use of this traders in our system very clearly. But in any case, all the suggestions are welcome. We'll definitely consider for the future. Thank you.
Good afternoon, sir.
So glad to hear about eNAM, One Nation, One Market. My question is to you is that so far 585 mandis have been deployed with eNAM. Then these all are done in the regulated market space. Then what is the case scenario and what are the challenges which are faced in unregulated markets like of Bihar? What are the steps have been taken to deploy eNAM in such markets?
Thank you. Good question. So when we gave this scheme, we prepared this scheme. Since agriculture marketing is a state subject, we had left it to the states to come up with the proposal. They come up with a DPR, detailed project report. We go through that to see whether, what are the various parameters, what are the uses, and based on that, once it is approved, then we it roll out. That means it's both are agreeing. That means state has put up and the center is looking into this, that it is as per what is required, because there are certain guidelines in it. So we moved this, 585 has come in this, two-way process into 16 states and two union territories. We'll be now expanding another 415 mandis by March 2020, that is end of the 14th Finance Commission, so to make it 1,000 by March 2020. But we'll not stop at that. We are now planning, let me go a step further. There are roughly 22,000 village huts in the country. If I add this 22,000 village huts to the 6,630 APMCs or regulated wholesale markets, the density will come down. That means accessibility will improve. So currently we are in the process of working through MG Narega of the Ministry of Rural Development and the states to improve the basic infrastructure and provide marketing infrastructure from our scheme, for which we have now recently launched a fund called Agriculture Market Infrastructure Fund, from which the states can avail the fund and then develop the marketing infrastructure while doing the basic infrastructure from the MG Narega. For those, all these huts do not do the wholesale trading. We are doing a survey through Directorate of Marketing. We find that about 4% of these village huts are currently in the wholesale trading, because when the season comes, another 24 is a combine of different types, wholesale and retail. So we'll be definitely bringing eNAM to the grams to form a kind of value chain, as proper supply chain. That means the farmer brings his produce to the village hut. He can sell it because he will have access to a national market. If the traders are not there, trader will be there in the eNAM platform. If the traders are not picking up from that village hut, then there can be the village hut can play the aggregation role, and they can be linked to the nearest APMC in a hub and spoke model. You know, hub and spoke model we have been dreaming of. It will create a hub and spoke model. And from APMC to APMC, and now we are making effort to bring the exporters, processors, and big retailers who are not directly buying from the APMC in the physical mandi space generally, very few are doing it. eNAM, we are now discussing with them. There is a huge interest to this big retailers and processors that the laboratories have been set up, assaying is happening, bidding is happening, there is a payment system which is available in this, electronic weighing scale is there. So it has generated a huge interest in this category, which was earlier not there in this. So, which means if you see, the farmer at the village heart can get access to his nearest APMC, traders, the traders of other APMCs, the exporters, the processors in the future, and the big retailers. And with the infrastructure improvement, definitely it will be easy, and linkage between these, the movement of the goods will be smooth. So when you are doing this, we have requested states like Bihar, which has no APMC Act at the moment, or even Kerala, to join this. Because we had three reforms mandated for this. One is e-trading has to be there in the Act. The other is the unified license procedure in the Act. The third is the single point levy of market fee. Why single point levy of market fee? Because earlier, fee was levied for the same commodity in its journey from one mandi to the other. It was subjected to the stress of the mandi fee. That means there is an escalation in the price. Same commodity. I'm not saying the same type of commodity. I'm saying the same commodity because, as I said, demand is pan-India. It will move from mandi to mandi. In Faridabad, recently I had gone, I saw the apple is coming from Kashmir to Faridabad, then going to Gurgaon. It will not stop at that. I'm sure it will go further. That's a trade, free-flowing trade. It's a market economy. So obviously, what will happen is that when we are improving the structures, you'll be happy to know that Kerala has now requested, which does not have APMC Act, they prepared the DPR for 6 such mandis. And we have already sometimes back before the election even, we had approved it very clearly because they are so keen to do it. They realized when they saw, they came to our meetings at different places we are doing meetings. They came and attended this meeting, went back with enthusiasm. Now they came back and we have already cleared it. Definitely, we are sure others will do. Like Manipur didn't have an act. So now they are in the process of, they have finalized their act. It had gone to the assembly. I'm told it has cleared the assembly. So now notification is pending. So depending on the state they'll come up with the proposal, we'll definitely welcome them. It's a matter of time only. Because there lies the interest of the farmers of that state. So obviously every government is keen on improving the welfare of the farmers. And certainly eNAM is one such platform which is bringing huge welfare to the farmer. Thank you.
Sir, in the starting of lecture, you were talking about the pan-India expansion of eNAM. Sir, the states like Punjab, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu are the key producers of pulses and grains, but still they are out of eNAM. And sir, in many cases, it has been seen that there is a failure of software to accommodate heavy volumes, and the restoration is done by NCDX eMarket, which is in the joint venture with Rashtri eMarket. So sir, what's your take on these issues? And sir, as a suggestion, I would like to add something that, for example, we are in a agriculture marketing institute, and combining the students of first year and second year, we are having a total strength of 112 students. So it should be added in our curriculum also that, for example, this is eNAM, and frankly speaking, many of us don't know how to operate this, and we are not having much knowledge about it. So what we can do is that we can have a workshop regarding this, and then each student should be given a task to go into the village, and at least he has to teach 2 farmers about the same platform. So in this way, we can create profit and show the farmer that there is someone who is taking pain for them. Second thing, it will be branding or of the own institute. And third thing, it will be beneficial for government also. Thank you, sir.
First of all, for your suggestions, I'll start from that end. Definitely, I'm most welcome if the students can spare their time to go to the village to take up 2 farmers. It's a yeoman service we'll be doing. So of course, Director General and the inter faculties there, they can build up. You have a village study module also that last year with Dr. S.R. Singh, we discussed that to re-Christian it and rejuvenate it. I'm sure when that is being done, you can do the eNAM. that can be there. And your suggestions to include it in the course curriculum is very well, and all the help that is required we'll be able to provide. All the resource person who can entirely teach you on this, spare time and teach you on this. That's very good. And good to know the entire in and out of eNAM, so that you can take it further as our brand ambassador to every corner of this country. Thank you very much. Coming to the second part, you said Punjab, Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, etc. They are not able to do the trade in the volume. There is problem initial phase, because when a technology comes, it has a, in the lifespan, there are various phases. When in the initial phase, in the build-up phase, when you are doing, if you read those phases, in the initial build-up phases, there will be teething problem because we are developing the software. Software is yet to be stabilized. So we are no different from that, because when a system study, you know how a system is developed. The system manager, system engineer will come. They'll study the entire process. They'll sit with us, understand, go back to the mandi. They'll see system, every stage they'll be studying in the mandi, because they are not the mandi people. They are the IT people. So they'll also understand the marketing system, entire space of market. Then when they start this with a program, obviously it will not be as per what is a kind of 100% expectation. Every system, anywhere in the world, not just in India, anywhere in the world. So in this phase, then certain adjustments are done, certain refinements are done on the platform to bring match stability to that platform, and then a growth phase. We have gone through that. We are going through this. In the built-up phase, when initially we had those problems, server problems, it was not because of the volume. It was because if at a time many transactions will come, the server used to stop. That was the initial part. But then when you analyze that, we worked on restructuring of the servers. Now those problems are passé. Passé means of the past history. And since this is a virtual platform, there is no limitations on your volume of trade. Physical market, you'll have limitation of trade. You know, in the gate entry, when the enters, the small and marginal farmers have small lots. But then the trader needs, as I said in my lecture, that they needs bigger lot. The big retailers will require much more. There is a process in the system whereby we can integrate the lots to make a revised lot for a bigger, or divide the lot, if it is a big volume he has brought in, for a smaller lot. Look at the flexibility that this system offers. You bring any amount of lot, it can be done. Even if you are bringing small lot, I can sell it to a bigger trader. Even if you are bringing the big lot, I can sell it to a smaller trader. That's a nicety, the flexibility of this platform. As you have spoken about the REMS, Rashtriya E-Market System Limited, there are two different things. eNAM is for the 16 states and 2 union territories, whereas REMS is purely confined to now Karnataka, which the NEML, the subsidiary of the NCDEX, had developed and put it. It is definitely much before eNAM came. They had put it in Karnataka through a JV, joint venture system. eNAM came other than the Karnataka, because Karnataka initially, since they had put in their markets, most of the markets, nearly I think 162 or 164 markets they had done before we came here. So obviously they didn't have scope immediately to take it. So when we started our journey, we went through the pain process, that the developmental process that the REMS went through. But believe me, now even eNAM has features which are very bold and powerful. We are yet to see in any other software today. It's very, very flexible. That is how we could start this interstate trade. REMS is yet to experience that interstate trade. And now, believe me, that Karnataka government, they have requested us to bring eNAM to the state, two mandis they have proposed. We are considering that, definitely we'll bring eNAM to Karnataka. And not only that, we'll not stop at that. Since RMS is already working in Karnataka, and Maharashtra, there are a different system in 25 markets where Maharashtra Agriculture Competitiveness Project with the help of World Bank, with the assistance of World Bank came up. Those 25 mandis, they have put the standalone software for e-trading in that mandi. Even intermandi has not started, so obviously scope of interstate trade doesn't arise. We are now looking at developing our interface and API so that we join ourselves with the RMS. That's the experiment we are doing now. So that we give the benefit of interstate trade to RMS. They'll be benefiting from our step that we have taken. So that is why you'll see eNAM is now growing at a pace that states are realizing that the way the technological platform has been strengthened, the user-friendly features have been done, it is not just, it is a continuous process of improvement that we are doing, not only technology, but also practices in the mandi. We are improving the mandi process. Very interestingly, so that is why the states are evincing keen interest on the eNAM to come forward. So we'll see that at one point of time we thought probably that why eNAM should be the only platform in India. So that is why we have offered interoperability to Karnataka, so that they should not be limited, their farmers should not be limited, because as ministry, our interest is the farmers, not any state. So that is why, like, we'll take them along, we'll join them, so the farmers can sell their produce to the traders here. And if the traders of Karnataka want to buy, because they're buying physically, they can also migrate to our eNAM. So they'll not know, because they'll trade through RMS and our people will trade through the eNAM. So interface we are developing on the backside, complex interface. So that will make the system very smooth. So after that, we'll also see all other, once we experience on this, we'll also go to other platforms that is there. We'll look into this, whether it is feasible to do it or we need to upgrade them. So our team is working hard on this, and it will be definitely, we'll ensure that in India we have smooth operations of the marketing for the farmer. Thank you.
I have done a project on eNAM at National Council of State Agriculture Marketing Boards. There, at that time, when I was studying it, all about eNAM, I got to find that of course eNAM has most of the features to connect the mandis all over the India. There are 585 mandis, but still intermandi interstate trade is not there. It hasn't achieved any peaks. It's almost negligible, we can say. So what is the ministry's take about that? And the second question is, around 1,21,000 traders are there who are registered on eNAM for trading. But for state, interstate mandi trade, we should have that single unified licenses for the traders to do intermarket trade in interstate. But many of the state governments haven't provided any of it. There are around 26,000 of these SULs all over the India. So what is it that governments are lacking to provide these single unified licenses? Thank you.
Thank you. When did you do your study with COSAM? COSAM, I believe.
Yes,
COSAM.
Sir. Yes, sir.
When did you do this study?
Sir, in June 2018.
We have now moved to March 2019.
Yes, sir. But the data I have given is on the website for now only.
Okay. During my deliberations lecture, I spoke about intermandi trade within the state and interstate trade. I said that you'll be happy to know that, again I'm repeating, you'll be happy to know that 11 states have now joined interstate trade. Second objective was the intermandi within the state, and third objective, the last objective, was that interstate trade. I also said that in December we started this. Somewhere from mid-December, we started this interstate trade after bringing states together, after a lot of discussions, we started it. Today, there are 10 states who have joined this. Volume may not be very high, They are covering the commodities like vegetables, fruits you are yet to start because the harvest season will now come. Vegetables, oil seeds, cereals, and spices. Spices, that is chili. Already in interstate trade, we have started that. We are expecting much more in the coming harvest because this is the first harvest season that we'll be facing. After the start of this interstate trade, we are preparing the mandis to take on themselves this interstate trade. We have prepared the dashboard for them. We have improved the traders' features so that they can, it's much more user-friendly. Because as I said, technological improvement on eNAM platform is not a stagnant thing. It's a continuous process. What was there yesterday, today we have moved away from there and definitely we'll be moving away tomorrow. Because of that, now it's become easy to do the interstate bidding, interstate kind of licensing, that the trader of other states can take a license quickly, which was unthinkable earlier. So that is why now 10 states are on the intrastate trade, that is intermandi within the state. 11 states have now joined interstate. I think yesterday it was Himachal and Chandigarh, yesterday or day before, that trade has happened first time. So that is why we are expecting much more. So that is why you'll realize that it's a journey we are making. Initially, we started within the mandi, went from mandi to mandi within the state because agriculture marketing is a state subject, step-by-step approach. Then we have now joined state to state. So of the 16 states and 2 union territories, 11 states and 1 union territory have joined this interstate trade. We'll definitely bring all the 16 of them, and then when you are expanding to all another 415, we'll bring more states. Like I said, Kerala, Karnataka, they'll be joining this 415 journey with us. What was any other question you said? Okay. Single unified license, you know, first was the Telangana. All their traders license, they declared as is where is basis as unified license. This was followed by, I said, Odisha and Uttarakhand. And then Andhra has now joined that, declaring all their traders license as unified license. That means they don't have to go and apply for separately. They can trade on the eNAM platform. The other states, they have their procedure for unified license. So they are moving on that platform. They are moving in that platform. And while doing it, they are also simplifying the entire license fee and the security deposit process, because that also needs a little bit of liberalization. Rajasthan is one state which has done a beautiful liberalization of this license fee and security deposit system. So that is why they are the one state where all the mandis have participated not only within the state in intermandi trade, but I think they have done it with 4 other states interstate trade. I mean, one state doing with another 4 states the interstate trade. So that is now it's happening. It has just started happening. So we'll see much more in the next, days to come, the months to come, and the years to come, certainly. Thank you. In fact, the first intermandi interstate trade was between Uttarakhand and UP, which happened actually because Uttarakhand was very keen because they don't get the price in the mountain. So, and their traders from UP, they buy it from Uttarakhand. So they said that eNAM will, and then the numbers has increased between these two.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Pankaj Gosain from Dehradun. So my question is that, as you have already told about the small and marginal traders, majority of the Indian farming community is composed of small and marginal farmers or small and marginal traders who still opt for or who still prefer to go through the cash mode of transactions or cash mode of payment, and so hence do not choose to trade through eNAM, which is online portal for the payment. So what is your take, or what has government already done or what it is planning to do in this case so that to promote eNAM? Because this section of the farming community basically chooses to go through the traditional methods just for the cash payment mode of transaction. So what would you say about it?
You know, when we started the journey, the percentage volume of trade through eNAM was very low. The gate entry, they never used to do. They used to take it through the gate but not enter in the eNAM system. We made a lot of effort with the states to capture that at the gate. And then when we captured at the gate, we saw that the e-trading is not happening because the Mandi secretary thought that probably simultaneously all traders, you have to train them. All the misgivings, you have to train them. Once we have done the training, we are realizing in place like Rajasthan, now they are capturing the entire volume in their gate entry. And I'm told about 45% of this entire volume in these mandis are traded through e-trading. What else you expect? I mean, it's a journey. We are improving day by day. What was there yesterday? Today it has changed. It's a digital era, digital world. So with this kind of volume, obviously we are going to see much more revolutions in the eNAM. So the idea that you have reflected is the idea of the yesteryears. But today, we have improved upon those ideas and we are moving forward. So definitely the question of not having, if only the cash would have determined in the market, then how is that the volume is increasing? In fact, the markets are doing innovations for the farmers. The place loan systems they are bringing for the farmers whereby against the commodity, like Maharashtra, they are giving the place loan to the farmers. So it is encouraging the market to come up with the innovations. It's just not the platform. The innovations, management innovations around that helps them, like the attraction through discounting on the market fee, because they don't need that much of market fee to be kept as surplus. So place loan system is one, they are doing it. Many of these states have started putting the warehouses where farmers can keep their stuff for a few days at a very discounted or even zero storage charges. That's a welfare. So obviously, when in the traditional system it was cash-based, yet we have tried to look into that space, we realized that when in the initial phase when it did that e-payment module, it was taking at least one day to reach the account. We worked intensively with the developer and the bankers to improve that, to bring it to half an hour. And then we encourage the state's mandi board, because we realize the traders are going even to the bank, even in earlier days, in the cash payment system, you are never able to track whether he's getting 100%. As I said, that there is a discounting in the interest rate. The trader may not give the 100% amount. He may discount it, may give half of it, one-fourth of it today, another half of it after a month, after the deal has been done and he has taken the stuff, maybe after some times. The farmer has to go after him. And the mandi didn't have any track record of it. When they told me that they are paying through check, I said, do you keep track of it? That also tracking is not there. So that is why when we went on improving this platform, we are realizing that now the traders are coming up, farmers are demanding it. Very clearly, and the mandis have started putting ATMs. Within half an hour goes to them, goes to the farmer, and he can draw the money from ATM, from the mandi, and pay for his whatever payment he has to do, he can do. So that is why we also did a little bit of innovations. It's not just putting a platform, but doing a little bit of process re-engineering in the entire system is very important. You'll know any new digital innovations, we'll have a little bit of process re-engineering around it. We are doing that continuous after taking a lot of feedback. So that is why the e-payment has moved up, and I'm sure it will move up very fast, because in India, we are accepting this e-payment as a better model. Because not only the farmer is benefited, the entire economy gets benefited, because the money circulation gets faster. The cost of money circulation reduces from the economist's point of view. So the cost of the economic activities then reduces and it becomes very efficient. And it is happening and it will happen. It will grow more. Thank you.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Rakesh Goda. So actually, under eNAM, there is a provision that farmers can trade his or her commodity without opting any of the commission agents.
So as of now, of course, we see that we are not seeing any such kind of transaction due to the literacy rate of Indian farmers. But for sure, in coming days, farmers will use this provision to the ultimate level. By this, all the middlemen and commission agents will get eliminated in future days. So my point is, whether it is a positive or negative thing for eNAM. And also, I just observed that, I mean, even in Karnataka, that RENS system which is going on there successfully, the main thing is they have considered all its stakeholders carefully. Because of that only, it is running in profitable manner. So my point is, ultimate point is, because of this eNAM also, the acceptance of eNAM is also getting affected by this provision. So whether the ministry should keep and continue this provision, or else whether the ministry should quash or amend this provision under eNAM.
What provision are you talking about?
I mean, without opting any of the commission agents, farmer can do trading by using his registered mobile apps. So this is there, but right now this is not happening. But in future days, this will going to happen, and it will eliminate all the middlemen and the commission agents in the system.
My second question is that when did you get a training in the NML's REMS system?
No, sir. I have personally.
Because two of you from the audience spoke so well about REMS. So I'd like to know, have you understood that or just
from
your say you are talking about?
No. I just observed personally, sir. I am from Karnataka and I have done training in REMS system.
Okay. If you have heard me talking about the REMS, sit down. It is through a JV. I'm told they're charging 0.1% from the farmers even. We don't charge a single penny from the farmers. We have more than 1.5 crore farmers on the eNAM platform today. And we would not have come up to this stage in a short span of time had we make it difficult for the farmers, first of all. Second, we have India has variety. The APMC Act, if you read, they are defined, depending on the states, the role of traders, the role of commission agents. Unfortunately, in some of the states, they have provided that the commission agents have to own these shops and even the platform, and in some states, the traders, mostly the commission agents. Because of that requirement of a physical space within the mandi, it put a limitations on the number of traders. Because the mandi has a limited physical space, few acres of land. It can accommodate only few commission agents because they have to be given the subs. So that is why in the physical mandi system in the traditional APMC, there is no scope of new traders to join, or hardly any scope rather. That means it was a limited number of traders who is to determine the price in that market. So that is why I said it's not a kind of even kill transactions between the farmer and the trader in the earlier system. But the virtual platform has no end to it. Anybody can join. If you simplify the registration process, and you don't need to own a commissioner or a trader doesn't have to own a shop or a platform to become a participant in that. They have a role. What role commission agent, if you look at it? They are putting a value addition to the system, unloading, loading, even they're taking for cleaning and grading, because you know, when the small farmers many times bring the stuff from the farm field, where there will be, which will require cleaning. There may be small stones, the earth or anything, admixture. So they need to be clean before they can get a value. It's a commission agent who provides that value addition services. Even when you are taking it for the laboratory assaying, it's a commission agent who is helping to take it. As a farmer, to know the entire market process is sometimes difficult. So that is why commission agent provides a service even he is loading it and he's settling the price, he's providing a service. So for that there is a commission charges which is inbuilt into the rule. It is not, there is no illegality in that. But then nicety of this eNAM is that it provides whether you have to come through the commission agent or you don't want to come through the commission agent. That exercise, that option is exercised at the gate entry, that first submodule. Why is it that? We realized in Madhya Pradesh, as I said, there are no commission agent system in their act of the rule. It's not just one state. So we have to cater to the heterogeneity in India. Because states have their own system. So that is why the option was provided to the farmer if they want not to come through the commission agent, they need not come. In Madhya Pradesh, fairly well, they are doing without a commission agent system in that. So you will see that this platform provides for all possibilities. And you have to distinguish between the middleman, you use the word called middleman, and the commission agent. You have to distinguish between the two. When you look at the World Bank literature, you come across the word called intermediation. In India, generally, they quote it as 5 to 6 minimum, whereas countries like USA, they say maximum 2, signifying that the supply chain or the value chain in USA has lesser of intermediation. So that means the farmer's share in the consumer's price is much better off. Whereas in India, because of the intermediation in various stages, the farmer's price on the consumer comes down. The effort is to reduce this intermediation. What is that reduction in the intermediation? The middlemen are like village commission agent. You know, how does it operate in India? Probably NIAM must have taught you. Since the farmer, small and marginal farmer, cannot go long distance by hiring a truck, which is very expensive for a small produce, which increases his produce. So obviously, many of the village commission agents buy it, aggregate it, give it to probably block level agents, to the district level agents, who then come to the wholesale agents, who then come to the district level. So probably by the time, sometimes when it reaches the APMC, there are other intermediation. When you are working with this system, we are allowing the farmer producer organizations to trade on this, cooperative to trade on it. Now we are finding the farmers are able to come together and do it here. We did also in the APLM Act a provision whereby the FPOs got the status of the farmer, which was not there in 2000 Act. So that means the FPOs will be able to come and deal with as a seller in the APMCs. That is attracting the farmers to the APMC. So that is why the farmers are able to now deal with the eNAM. But the intermediation prior to this wholesale, that is the village commission agent, obviously the price is very low compared to the APMC. So once the intermediation comes down, if they are able to come to APMC, that means this intermediation which you call the middle man, they can be reduced because, you know, middleman, every time a middleman is there, that is village commission agent, this thing, there is a possibility of the loss of the item, loading, unloading, and improper storage and handling. So that is why if you cut down the intermediation, then the loss also reduces. You know, one of the report, beautiful report of World Bank says, what UK consumes in fruits and vegetables, probably India waste more than that. The wastage in India is more than that. Why? Because our supply chain was not developed. Our intermediation is so high. It was not an integrated system. So that is why when I agree with you, the middleman has to come down. But the commission agent, you have to distinguish between the two, the service commission agent or the service provider. And in the eNAM, while we are bringing transparency in the system that the commission agent and the trader together cannot play with the farmer, that certainly we are ensuring they cannot play with the system, they'll provide more of value additions. India needs value additions. So when the interstate trade improves, there will be requirement of the transportation, logistic, storage at third party, third city. After even buying by a distance trader, he may like to store it, and before that he would like to get it once again asset. So those are now a new class of service providers will be required, which is beyond the APMC Act. When you look at the interstate trade, so that point between a mandi, when it exits from the gate to entry of the gate, those services where probably the APMC Act may not address, there you need a service provider. And these commission agents can play a beautiful role apart from others. For that reason, Telangana has last year come up with a category on the service provision, service provider category. Realizing the importance of this category, they have come up with it. UP traditionally has given a provision of, in their system, a transportation, which is not a part of the act, but then somehow they have provided in the rule, I'm told. So that means now we'll be looking further to integrate markets across India, and these commission agents, many of the commission agents already provide the outside this eNAM in the physical mandi, outside the mandi, the transportation services. We learned that. So they can be, when we are now developing a logistic platform, the eNAM, to join these mandis. Logistic platform is under development. So we will not be just doing a mandi function, but the logistic function also will come in integrated. So there a new class category of service provider will come up. So the entire transformation is happening. So that is the thing I wanted to tell you. Thank you. Okay. Thank you. So you feel hungry?
Maybe another maximum 2-3 questions we can entertain, because it is already 1:30.
Okay.
So
you are asking me question. Next session, I'll be asking you questions. So get ready. Have enough of energy, fuel. Of course, I'll not put you into any difficulty. It will be helping you out. Because I have a dream for all of you. And that dream is to see you as the successful manager. Because, you know, if you are able to challenge the students from IIMs in their game, it will be a dream for me come true. That is what I was looking for that day. So that is why this seminars that I had told has to be beyond the agribusiness. It has to be management space. So that you do your reading, because the entire night is there. The group can be heterogeneous, boys and girls. Come up with that idea. That will be nice.
Maharashtra government gave the permission that farmer or traders can trade inside the APMC or even outside the APMC. So is it contradictory to eNAM? Because it will happen only in APMC. Later, after Maharashtra government cancelled this ordinance, but it happened. Does it contradict to eNAM? Or another one question, that it is said that some political pressure or some lobby is working against eNAM. Is it there?
Well, it has two parts to this question. Let me break it up. First is that the act reforms of the act, State Agriculture Produce Marketing Committee Act. The other is the eNAM. When this APLM Act was rolled out with a persuasion to the states to adopt these features, already 2003, good many features are there, but APLM Act, model APLM Act 2017 has more features than 2003 Model Act. So in that, you know, 2003 Act took quite long to be adopted. Some of the features, we are about 21 states have adopted, but after a long gap of 12 to 15 years. But 2017 Act, when you did it, we are moving up first, because Uttar Pradesh has done it, Chhattisgarh has done it, Arunachal has done it, Punjab has done partially. It is much faster than the 2003. When you bring a reform, typically, if you read some of the literature on the reforms of economy, reforms of any sector, there is an initial part, there is a pen process, there is opposition. It's a democracy. When 91 reforms came, economic reforms, there are also opponents. But then Thereafter, it moved up. India was going through a difficult stage, but then they came up very nicely. And it established India as one of the, it showed that Indian brains work much better than any other brain. Reforms are very innovative. So initial process to explain the reform takes time. To onboard everybody, democracy has got every type of people. You have to onboard them in the reform. So when you do the market reform, that is another point of reform, there will be opposition. I'm not saying lobby or anything, I say generally the opposition. So it's the state, since it's the Agriculture Marketing Act, states have to explain to everybody, take on board. And that is what the states are doing. So when the reforms are come, in this 2017 Act, you'll see it's a marked departure from the 2003 Model Act, in a sense that the regulation practices has to be differentiated from the operations. That is, any regulation, regulatory regime today, regulatory reforms, whether it is USA or India, the effort is to segregate the regulator from the operator. But in our system, in the physical mandi, it was the same regulator was also performing as the operator, meaning thereby that the MD Mandi Board was the license giver. He was the director of marketing, MD Mandi Board, and he was also the operator of the mandi. Because of that, probably there are challenges to bring up the private mandi. All the mandis were government-backed mandis. When you have to bring the private mandis, it was necessary to bring private investment into this because government has limited resource, and any setting up a mandi is a very capital intensive. And government cannot just put in mandi. They have different sectors of economy or social areas where they have to invest their resources. So definitely there was a need to bring in private resources on the complementary basis. In that process, you realize that there is a need to segregate this. And 2017, if you go through that act, then it talks about segregation of director marketing from the head of the mandi board. That means head of the mandi board, MD, will only manage the operations that is mandi, all the mandis. Whereas the director of marketing, who is a part of the government, whereas the mandi board is a board, but the director of marketing, who is a part of the government, he can give the licenses or registration process, whatever the act or the rule provides, to bring in that confidence in the private investor. Similarly, there is one more reforms that was talked about, that mandi was not only collecting fees from within the boundary for whatever trade was happening within the boundary, also was collecting fee for the trade happening outside the mandi, but so-called area of the mandi in a honeycomb approach. That means the entire state was divided into the honeycomb, where each mandi had got a separate area from which they used to collect fee. And the collection of fee was for development. They have to plow it back for, apart from their expenditure, establishment expenditure, they will have to also use it for the developmental purpose. But then, here in this case, what happened is that we realized that when they are taking it outside, but the much of development was not happening. So that is why, and the private mandis are not coming up. So now, it is market fees limited to collecting for whatever trade is happening within their physical boundary. So when you bring such kind of drastic changes into the system, you have to onboard everybody, so there will be opposition. It's a matter of time that it happens. UP has already done it. So Maharashtra is in the process. They have set up a committee now, going into detail of it. They'll be doing it. So it's a matter of time. Reforms takes time, and it will be a matter of time. And 2017 reform is much faster than the 2003 reforms category. I can assure you at least on that. Thank you.